and a teacher, a hooker and a preacher, riding on a midnight bus bound for Mexico. One was headed for vacation, one for higher education, and two of them were searching for lost souls. That driver never ever saw the stop sign, and 18-wheelers can't stop on a dime. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That farmer left to harvest a home and 80 acres, the faith and love for growing things in his young son's heart. And that teacher left her wisdom in the minds of lots of children, and did her best to give them all a better start. And that preacher whispered, can't you see the promised land, as he lay his blood-stained Bible in that hooker's hand. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That's the story that our preacher told last Sunday, as he held that blood-stained Bible up for all of us to see. He said, bless the farmer and the teacher and the preacher who gave this Bible to my mama, who read it to me. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, now I guess we know. It's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway.
All right, friends, welcome into the Gospel Music Jukebox one more time. Program back to back. We just got done doing a program a little bit earlier, but we didn't get a finish. Amen. So we're going to be on for about an hour or so. Amen. So thank you once again for your prayers, your patience, and for just being who God has formed you to be. If you're born again, bathed in the blood, you know what I'm talking about. If you're listening tonight and you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, well, right now, right there, right where you're at, today is the day of salvation. Won't you reach out and grab a hold of the unchanging hand of the great I Am, my friend? Reach out, take a hold, get things settled between you and God before you run out of time. Listen, you don't have the promise of the next heartbeat you are to take. Hey, death could find you right there where you're at. Are you ready? You're either going to spend eternity in heaven or hell. Choose you this day. Whom will you serve? It's in your hands. What are you going to do with Jesus Christ? We pray you reach out, take a hold of that unchanging hand. Amen. All right, praise God. We're going to be sharing some testimonies, some calls. Our live call-in number is not working tonight. The phone line is down for some apparent reason, but that's all right. You can call the testimony line 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. You can call as many times as you'd like. We're going to share those on future programs and this one. You can dial 1-931-229-0768. And get involved. Share your testimony, your Bible question. Share a word with us. Maybe a song. Well, just simply obey God. You'll be blessed, we'll be blessed, and the listeners will be blessed. Amen. So be an overcomer. Pick up the phone. Yes, dial 1-931-229-0768. Get involved. Help us. We need your help. This ain't no one-man radio program. No, it's a body of Christ. And I'm crying out. I'm asking you, if you're born again, bathed in the blood, pick up the phone. Let the world know that you're not ashamed. Let the world know that you're an overcomer. Yes, by the word of your testimony and the blood of the Lamb. Smack the devil right upside the head in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. I want to thank Brother Boyd Thomas London for jumping into the chat room. Amen. He says, God bless all. He called in a couple of times. Thank you, brother. I'll get over there just in a moment. Check those phone lines. He says, we love you all, and we are praying for you. Amen. Know that right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox, you got some prayer warriors. You hear me? You got prayer warriors right here. We're going to pray for you. We don't care what your burden is, your trouble is. We want to go to the Lord in prayer with you and for you, because we know that God's not dead, and we know that God hears the prayers and that he's still alive and he answers prayers. Yes, he's still in the miracle working business. He's still the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, for he changes not. What he did for them of old, he'll do for you and I right here, right now. Now, that means blessing or cursing. You got to take it from Genesis to Revelation. We're talking about the whole Word of God, not just bits and parts, not just your favorite verse, not my favorite verse, we're talking about the whole Word of God. We're preaching the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ, to a lost and dying world. We need your help. Pick up the phone, get involved. Those of you that listen live or by way of the archive, please, I encourage you, I challenge you to get involved with us, and here's how you can do it. You can be a laborer right here in the ministry, not only with your phone calls, but you can encourage your family members, your friends, your co-workers, and yes, even your enemies. Share the program. Share the number. Write it down. Give it out. Tell them. When you're down, you need prayer, call it. We'll share it on a radio program. We'll burn it on a CD. My God, just think of the possibilities of hundreds of people praying for you and your situation. Ain't that awesome? We know that God hears the cries of his children. So get involved. Be a laborer right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. Also, I want to let those ministers know, those evangelists, the prophets, apostles, those of you that's called and chosen by God. Yes, the servants, the children of God. That's you, my friend. Amen. I want you to pray about really, really putting your hands on the plow here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. I want you to pray about doing a program. It's simple. You just email me, or you can leave a comment here in the comment box. Get a hold of me, or you can call my cell phone number. It's 1-931-335-1440. Call me. Say, hey, I want to DJ a program. I'll give you the sign-in information. I'll give you the log-on password. We'll pick a time, pray it through, and you'll come on the air and you can do a program. The only requirement that we have is that you obey God. As long as you stay in the Word and the will of God, hey, I'm not going to bother you. I'm going to encourage you to keep on keeping on and do whatever God tells you to do. You know, something that really gets my goat a lot of times and gets under my skin is when someone says, you know, like if they're doing a hosting a program for us or a visitor here in the studio, and they say a comment like, well, I'm going to say this, and Brother Eddie may not invite me back. Why would you say that? You already doubt that I'm going to jump you for obeying God? Come on, I ain't that away. You know me better than that. Those of you that listen to the program, listen, all I've ever encouraged anyone to do is obey God. I do my very best to get that up front and out in the open. Please, obey God. Amen. That's what I encourage you to do, whether you co-host a program or whether you come live right here to the studio and do a program. Just obey God. Share the word of God through song, word, testimony. Amen. Just obey God, and it's always going to be good. Amen. I don't care about your denomination. I care about where you stand with God. You understand? I work with people in the Baptist, the Methodist, the Pentecost. I work with people in Church of God. I work in every denomination you can name. I'm involved with somebody in there, and we're trying to get the gospel and the truth preached into this, these different denominations out there. Now, you got to understand something about me. When I'm preaching, and I'm preaching against denominationalism, I'm not preaching against denomination. You got to know the difference. A lot of people get that confused. Amen. If God give you a name to put on your building and you prayed that through, hey, I'm not coming against that. All I'm saying is, if God told you to go out and get a building, back it up with the word. If God told you to hold a committee and vote for who's going to be your elders, your deacons, your pastor, I'm just saying, show it in the word of God. Back it up with the word of God. See, I'm just proclaiming the truth. That's all. Now, if you can't back that up, then you got concern to be worried. You really do, because tradition of men have been passed down. You understand? The wolf is good at his job, my friend, and he's in sheep's clothing. He's going to look good. But you can be assured of this. He's not going to preach you the full truth. He's going to dissect it, chop it up, and give you just bits and pieces that you'll hang on what time he pollutes you with garbage. And that's the truth. And thank God there's people like Brother Boyd and people like myself and many others. Just, you can find them on Facebook. You can find them on all kinds of public sites, radio, AM, FM. They are men and women of God all over this world that are standing up and preaching the truth. So if you find yourself at a place, I don't care about the name above the door. It could be at McDonald's where you gather together and worship the Lord. But if you find yourself at a place and they're calling for meetings to vote about things that the head of the ministry, the pastor, the voice piece for God, they're voting about things and he really has no say-so and they cut him out. I would be aware of that. I'd be leery. I'd want to know why that's going on. I know God can set a pastor, and that pastor is going to be held accountable to God, and he's going to be held accountable to the body of Christ. If you've got a problem with your pastor, you need to go talk to him, and you need to sit down and say, show me, and sit down and take time to discuss the problem that has come up before you just holler, let's get a committee, I'm calling for a meeting, and let's vote this and vote that. Now listen, if majority rules, then something's wrong, because the word of God should rule your ministry, your life. Yes, it really should. You should be living according to the word of God. Not let's vote about whether or not we're going to have a singing once a month. Why would you need to vote about that? Don't make no sense. Or let's vote about if we're going to build another sanctuary or another kitchen on. If God put it on your heart, you go to the pastor and you say, Pastor, God's placed it upon my heart, and I want to build a kitchen, a bigger kitchen. I want to remodel. And you pray about that, and the man of God will tell you yay or nay. But to vote on it, here's what happens when you bring politics into the worship and the house that they say is called the house of God. What happens is it becomes politics, not prayer. Oh, they pray and open their meetings up, but it's still a politic. Because if you want to win something in there and you want to get it pushed through, you got to get out and politic throughout the congregation and tell them you need them to show up at these meetings, and you need them to when they say, who says yay, aye, who says aye, you need to vote if you want us to put in a new baptistry, you know, or you need to vote if you want us to keep this same pastor for 3 more years. You need to show up and get involved and vote. Show me all that biblical, because I believe God sets those in authority over us. Now, whether we like them or not, whether they're what we would call anointed or not, really has nothing to do with that. It really don't. if a pastor's called by God, then he's going to pastor the flock, and he's going to make the decisions concerning the house of God. Now, he won't make them alone. If he's called by God, he will ask you for your prayers. He will discuss things with you. He will ask you to go into prayer and fasting with him, and you will do it together. But he has to. There has to be one head, not five, not seven, not three, not 27, but one that makes those godly decisions. And if you're a praying church, you'll pray for your pastor, and you'll pray that he stays in the will and the word of God, and you will check him against the word of God. Yes, many spirits come at you. You must try the spirit and see if it be of God. And you do that by lining it up with the word of God. Now, we're in the end days. Whether you like it or not, believe it or not, it's not going to change the fact that time is running out. And something's wrong when you look at the majority of all these different denominations. And they are allowing anything and everything to go on in these so-called houses of God. Yeah, like same-sex marriage. Yes, like strobe lights and smoke screens, and they're putting on concerts to fill the building. They're even running commercial ads that say, come worship with us, no perfect people allowed. You don't feel like you're in church. If I go to a place that's been dedicated and prayed for and been given to God, I want to feel the anointing and the presence of God. You understand? I don't want to feel like I'm at a bar. I go into bars and preach and testify and tell people the good news. And it's a honky-tonk. I mean, there's cussing, fighting, fussing, loud music, cigarette smoke, alcohol everywhere. And I know that I'm in a bar. When I go to a place that's been dedicated for God, a place of worship where we should be able to assemble ourselves together, then I want to feel like I'm in a building that's been dedicated and given to God, with liberty to obey God. You know, show me where these time schedules got into effect. Show me biblically where we start at 5, we quit at 7. I mean, show me this. Show me where it says to put a lock on the house that's been given to God. The house of God is a house of refuge. It's supposed to be a place where the sick can go. It's a hospital. It's a place where the men and women of God can go any hour, any time of the day or night and hit an old-fashioned altar. They can call for the elders. They can meet there. They can be prayed one for another. There's many things that goes on in these places that's been given to God. Now, we're the church. I'm not going to call these buildings a place of worship, the church. I just don't do that. It's not in me to do that, because that's not the church. The church is you. The church is I. If we are born again, bathed in the blood, we are the church. Now, stand up with the truth. Look at your church gathering, the body, the people. Yes, you and I. And then just check what you're doing. Are you worshiping God in spirit and truth? Or are you there to be seen? Are you there playing the politic game? Are you there to push your ideal? Are you there to, well, a tax write-off? Many people go just to get a tax write-off. They give to the church because they make so much money, and then if they give to the church, they get it back because the church helps their family, their cousins. You know, it's kind of like a country club syndrome thing. You know, well, what, you know, I tell people all the time, I have a tax-exempt number. I'm a licensed, ordained minister. I've been ordained by many elder ministers over the years. A lot of them are passed and gone on to be with the Lord. They're not here. Some are still here. But here's the point. I don't use those numbers. That is a trick of the devil. You understand? To get that tax-free exempt number and think you're getting something free, there ain't nothing free. It comes with a cost. Now, the government is threatening to pull these numbers and pull these benefits if they don't perform the same-sex marriage in these different denominations. Listen, what's wrong with just being a man or a woman that fell in love with God and just obeying the word of God? And if people want to sow and give into your work and your ministry that God's called you to do, they just simply do it out of the goodness and love of their heart. They're not looking for a tax break. They're not looking for a gimmick. They're just looking to obey God. There's a difference, and it shows. The tree is known by the fruit that it bears, my friends. One thing I pray, as long as I'm alive, you'll always hear the truth right here through the Gospel Music Jukebox. Now, I do invite many ministers. So far, not a lot of them took us up on the invite, but I invite them. If one happens to come that preaches anything other than the gospel, other than the word of God, I'll rebuke him and I'll deal with him and I'll talk to him and I'll correct him and show him in the word where he was wrong. And if he wants to continue to obey God, I'm for it. But if he rebels, I'll rebuke him and I'll take him off the air. That's the bottom line to that. Because God has called me to raise the Gospel Music Jukebox. Just like a pastor, I'm an evangelist in charge of this radio program. And you better believe, if you step out of the will of God, I'll flip the switch after I talk to you. Not before, because it could be a mistake. Maybe you was burdened that day. Maybe the enemy hammered you 1,000 times harder. So we got to find those things out, see? I'm man enough, I'll come sit down with you and we'll break bread. But you shouldn't have to worry about that, because I encourage you to obey God. Listen, listeners, I need your help. If you're born again, bathed in the blood, I want you to pray about getting involved with the Gospel Music Jukebox. I want you to pray about coming or doing a program from right there where you live. If you've got internet access, a computer, and a soundboard, you can do this. And you can share the gospel. And you can get your local ministers to come in and share a word. And you can share your songs and what's going on at your ministry. We'd love to hear about it. It ain't just about what's going on here in Crossville, Tennessee. I want to hear what's going on all over the world, because I know God is God in Alabama, he's God in Texas, he's God in Tennessee, he's God in Kentucky, he's God all over. Amen. And I'm reaching out and asking for help. Now, if you don't like my preaching style, just simply show me with the word where I'm wrong. If you do that, we'll talk about it. You understand? But if I make you mad and you get in the word and it helps you, so be it. Stay mad at me. You know, stay mad at it. I don't care, as long as you get it right between you and God. That's what's going to count in the end, my friend, is where your relationship is with Jesus Christ. Have you died? Have you surrendered all over? Are you allowing God's will to be done in your life? Then how come it's so hard for people like me and Brother Boyd and many others that ask for help? And many, many of you say, I've got letters. Many say, well, my ministry, they won't let me do nothing. Well, we want to give you an opportunity to do something for God right here. You can call at least once a day and share your testimony. Yeah, at least once a day. Just dial 1-931-229-0768. Share your testimony. You can call and share a song. Hey, what about praying for the needs of others? What about praying for those that are addicted to alcohol and drugs? We'll share it on the radio. You call in, you pray for them. See, there's plenty to do. So the day of excuses for you, if you've listened to this program, has run out. What are you going to do with Jesus? And what are you going to do with men and women of God like ourselves that get up, get in your face and say, now, you say you're born again. You say you love God. Then why won't you help us? We're on the same side. Why won't you take 3 minutes and call in a testimony? Why won't you take 3 minutes and call in a song? Why won't you take 3 minutes? Are you too busy to help a brother that's crying? The Bible says if a brother asks you to go a mile, you're to go twine. Listen, I'm asking you for help. Will you pray and seek God? Will you jump a hold, get a hold of the plow? Will you jump aboard? Help us here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. Start off little by calling the testimony line. Sharing a Bible question, sharing your comments about the program. We would love to hear from you. Call in and share what's going on, your testimony. Tell what God's doing. Tell us about the miracles. Tell us about what you're going through. Share. Let the world know that God's not dead. And we need your help to do that. We need your help. We need you to obey God, because God told me to ask. That's why I got to continue to ask. I will continue to ask and ask. And man, does it make people mad, like Brother Boyd was sharing earlier. It makes people mad when you call out sin. It makes the world mad when you say, hey, choose you this day, whom will you serve? Bottom line, if you've listened or listening to the Gospel Music Jukebox, it's time for you to get involved. We're asking you, pick up the phone, call. Share your testimony. Share the number. Give it to your friends, your family. Encourage them to be a part. Share the program as much as you can. over and over, hundreds of thousands of times. We're running out of time, man, and their souls hanging in the balance. That's the truth. We've got to get the Word of God out any way we can, through the radio, through the TV, through the CDs we give away, the VCR tapes. We give away everything and anything we can that we can get the gospel on, the prayer cloths, the prayer crosses. We give those away. Remember, if you'd like to receive anything from us, 219 Red Fox Drive, Crossville, Tennessee, 38571. My cell, my prayer line number. If you'd like to have live prayer or if you'd like to discuss anything with me, you dial 1-931-335-1440. If the phone rings, I'll answer it. If I'm in a dead zone, I'll get back with you. You can also text that number. Text us. But I'm asking you to get up and get involved. I'm asking you to help us. I ain't wanting you. It ain't about you sending me money. It's about you giving time. It's about you giving time and sharing the Word of God that God has installed in you, my friend. That's what it's about. Amen. So come on. I'm looking forward to those phone calls. I'm looking forward to the comments, the testimonies, the songs. You can call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. You can call our testimony line, 1-931-484. No, that's the live number. I'm sorry. Whoa, I started to give you the live number, and it's not working tonight. But I'm going to tell you about the live number just in a minute. But our testimony line is 1-931-229-0768. Call it. Get involved. Now, when we're on the air live and the live phone is working, it's worked up to this point, but something to do with the main phone line. If you call in, you want to participate live, you want to preach during a live program, you call in and we'll give you the floor. Amen. An hour, hour and a half, whatever you want. You just dial 1-931-484-4531. And if it's working and we're on the air live, we will just tell you to obey God. Now, can it get any plainer and can it get any easier than that? We want to give you the opportunity to do something for God. We want you to jump aboard the Gospel Music Jukebox. If you want to do a whole program, you just simply call me on my cell phone. We'll hook you up with that. We want to help you by you helping us. And let's go together and get the Word of God out to a lost and dying world. Hey, man. All right, guys, I love you. I was kind of hoping that Sister Rachel, but her phone was going dead. Man, awesome testimony a while ago on the other program. I believe it was 8. They got water baptized. A couple of my grandchildren. My God, I wish I could have been there. My wife was there, I believe, but she went to the service. She's down there visiting her mother and family there in Whitesburg, Kentucky. And, you know, it just had to be an awesome moment. I can't wait to hear about it. I love hearing what God's doing. Amen. Praise God, because, man, it's good. God is good. And I can't help it. I get plumb beside myself. I get excited. All right, enjoy this song as you listen here to the Gospel Music Jukebox. Remember, I'm your host, Evangelist Eddie Chaney. And also, I would encourage you to check our archives out. Hey, we got an awesome, awesome evangelist, Brother Willie Grizzle. He does the House of Prayer. Get over there, check that out. And as well, he has a testimony line. You want to give it a call or leave your prayer request. The same thing. I download his program. I burn those to a CD. So get involved. Help us get the Word of God out, my friend. We're crying loud and sparing not. And remember, on Facebook, if you're a listener and you're a friend on Facebook, on our Facebook page, Evangelist Eddie Chaney, you got to know I'm going to be sending invites to you once a week, maybe more, inviting you to utilize the phone lines. I'm going to be tagging you in our programs and our commentaries, the scripture that we share. I'm going to be tagging people. If you don't like that, ain't going to do you no good to complain to me. Just simply defriend me and move on. I'm praying that God's will be done in your life and our life. but I'm not going to debate it with you. I'm not going to argue with you, because I'm only on Facebook to share the gospel. I'm not there to chit-chat. I'm not there to play games, so don't send me. And I know sometimes they do it automatically. It does you no good to send me game requests. I don't play games. I mean, my time is dedicated to getting the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ, out to a lost and dying world. But know this. You need to know these things about me. But now, if you're interested in helping us, then share our Facebook page. Share our commentaries. Get in there. Ask questions. Share the gospel. That's how you become a laborer in the body of Christ, by being a doer of the Word of God. You got a brother right here. If you're born again, bathed in the blood, I'm your brother, and I'm asking for help. Are you going to go twine with me, or are you just going to walk on by because you're too busy playing games, wasting time, arguing and fussing about things that ain't going to get you nothing but a headache? Or are you going to pick up the phones, get involved, and be a doer of the Word of God? It's your choice. I pray that you get involved and obey God. You do that, we'll be blessed, you'll be blessed, and the listeners will be blessed, my friend. And that, I do know, will happen. It's in your hands. What are you going to do with it? I guess time will tell. I'll see who calls. I'll see who don't. I'll see. But I'm going to keep sending those prayer requests. I'm going to keep tagging you. So if that bothers you, pray for me as you say goodbye. And just defriend me, because I'm praying for you that God's will continue to be done in your life, and that God will bless you as you continue to be a blessing to others. All right. God bless. Enjoy the song. We'll be right back. Amen. And I want to send this song out to Daniel. I've not heard from Daniel in a while. Been on my heart. I love that young man. This is one of his favorites. It's one of mine. So be blessed as we listen, and we'll be right back as we check our phone lines just in a moment.
There's a long black train coming down the line, feeding off the souls that are lost and crying. Rails of sin, only evil remains. Watch out, brother, for that long black train. Look to the heavens, you can look to the sky. You can find redemption staring back into your eyes. There is protection and there's peace the same. Burn in your ticket for that long black train. Cause there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. There's an engineer on that long black train, making you wonder if the ride is worth the pain. He's just waiting on your heart to say, let me ride on that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory. Thank you. whistle from a mile away. It sounds so good, but I must stay away. That train is a beauty, making everybody stare. But its only destination is the middle of nowhere. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Claim to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. I said claim to the Father and His holy name. Watch out, brother, for that long black train. That devil's driving that long black train.
Oh, Brother Eddie, we love you, and we're praying for you. God bless you all. We love you all. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho, and I was just going to call in and share a little bit about what Jesus has been doing here. God is good, and Jesus is good, and I thank Jesus so much for healing us all and for helping us all. Thank you, Jesus, for healing and for helping us all. We love you, Jesus. And, yeah, my grandma Naomi was in the hospital for a while with pneumonia, and a lot of people prayed for her, and she's back home now, and she's doing well, and she's strong. She can walk around a little by herself using her walker and everything, and Grandma Naomi sends her love and thanks everyone for the prayers. My mom Jerry had that surgery for the kidney stones, had the stent put in for a couple weeks, and she's still a little sore for that, and she can use some prayers, but they got the kidney stones out, and she's doing well. My friend Wayne, who's in prison, we sent him a Bible and stuff, been helping him out, and he's doing well in the prison system. Wayne Kingsford appreciates the prayers. My friend Dusty, who was in the gangs and on the drugs, they moved him here from Ohio because he was going to get killed in the gangs back there, and we started praying with him and helping him, and he's been drug-free now for about 3 years, but his father just got out of prison. Dusty's father's did, and moved here, and he was in prison for assault charges, and we didn't know if he was going to start attacking people here and beating Dusty up again. You know, he used to hurt Dusty and hit Dusty, but he got here, and we've been praying for him, and I've had some great visits with him, spent time working with him. He's just been just really nice and great. It's been great spending time with Dusty's father, who was in prison, and we're praying that he will get saved and become a Christian. We need prayers for Dusty's father to get saved and to become a Christian, and also, my cousin Mikkel, she was in prison at one point for a DUI, and then one of her friends in there, Melinda, was in there for severe drug use, and we helped Melinda out, go through the Walden Rehab Drug Program, and Melinda's doing well. She's been drug-free for a while, but Mikkel never became a Christian, and she's married. Her husband was in prison and got out, and they have 3 kids. They're going to have another kid. But Mikkel and her husband and family have all just recently started going to church. And we just praise and thank God because I used to try to give her Bible scriptures and things when I was helping them out in prison there. And she never wanted to look at the Bible scriptures. But recently we've been praying for her, and she's turned her life over to Jesus, and her family is now going to church. So it's just so important to pray for all of these people, people in our families, our friends. We need to pray for them that they'll accept Jesus and get saved. And I just thank Jesus so much for working through us and seeing all these great things happen here. And we love you all, and God bless you. Amen.
Gladly walk across the desert with no shoes upon my feet to share with you the last bite of bread I had to eat. I would swim out to save you in your sea of broken dreams, but all your hopes are sinking. Let me show you what love it's time? Don't you think it's time? I would whisper love so loudly every heart could understand. But love and only love can join the tribes of man. I would give my heart's desire so that you might see. The first step is to realize that it all begins with you and me.
Love can build a bridge between your heart and mine. Love can build a bridge. Don't you think it's time? Don't you think it's time?
About what's all going on here, and I wanted to call in and just say a prayer here for everyone, just for people to be able to really turn their lives over to Jesus and for Jesus to help us all. Father, I love you with all my heart, mind, and soul. I want to come to you in prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you for Jesus dying on the cross for our sins. It says, Father, in the book of Matthew that if we'll turn our hearts and lives over to Jesus, that Jesus will heal us, and I just thank Jesus so much for healing us and for helping us, and I ask you, Jesus, just to heal us and to help us, and please help people to turn their lives over to you. I know I have people in my family, and I still have friends, Dusty's father, people who haven't yet surrendered their lives over to you and made you their personal Lord and Savior. And Father, I'm asking in the name of Jesus that the love of Jesus will just come into people's hearts and lives, that your love will come into their hearts and lives, and that they'll truly just love you and fall in love with you like I did, like my brothers and sisters have done, and they'll see how much you love us, and that they'll just surrender their lives over to Jesus and fall in love with you, and will from then on be changed and to live for Jesus, doing His will in your kingdom. And I'm just praying for all of us and for all these people, for my friends, for the people in my family, and Brother Eddie's family, Brother Willie's family, Rachel's family, and all of our families. I know there's so many people yet that need to find Jesus and have Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior so they can get saved, and I'm praying for that and asking for that right now. And Father, I do want to pray and ask for healing of us all, for anyone who needs healing. It's promised that Jesus will heal us. Matthew 8:17 says that He took our infirmities and carried our sicknesses. We are healed by the stripes, wounds, in the name of Jesus. Isaiah 53:4-5. Psalm 103 says, "You forgive all of our iniquities, heal all of our diseases, and redeem our life from destruction." I know there's so many prayer requests and people who need prayers with failing kidneys, cancer, different diseases, and I claim our healing right now of all of us, me and my food allergies, by the stripes, wounds, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. We walk by faith, not by sight, and by faith we are healed, we are healed, we are healed. And I praise you and thank you, Father, that we are healed. Thank you, Jesus, for healing us and for helping us all. And I love you so much, Father, and I just thank you so much for healing all of us and for helping just many people, those people that don't know Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior, for them to turn their lives over, our family and friends, to Jesus so they can get saved and also go to heaven. Thank you so much, Father, for hearing this prayer, and I praise you and glorify you, honor you, and pray this prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless all.
With no place to call my home, but there's one who holds my hand, the rugged road through barren lands. The way is dark, the steep, but He's become my eyes to see, the strength to climb, my griefs to bear. The Savior lives inside me there. In Your haven from my
Well, Brother Eddie, I love you, and I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you all. God bless you all. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. And, you know, if Jesus could say something to the world today and to the Christians and the people out there, I believe that he would say, where are the workers? Where are the workers? Remember, he said, the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. The harvest is plentiful, and the workers are few. See, everybody's saying, Lord, Lord, like in Matthew chapter 7 here, and going to church and saying, Lord, Lord, then they just go home and live their own lives. But this says here, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father in heaven. Many will say to me on that day, Lord, Lord, we not prophesied in your name, cast out demons, and done many wonders in your name, then I will declare unto you, I never knew you, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. See, the harvest is plentiful, and the workers are few. Everybody's saying, Lord, Lord, and going to church. But where are the people that will call in and share testimonies? Testimonies change people's lives. It says they overcame them by the word of their testimony in the book of Revelation. Why don't people want to share testimonies? They don't want to share them. Sharing testimonies is part of doing the will of God. Praying for others is part of doing the will of God. The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. There's not many Christians, people who call themselves Christians, who will sit there and actually pray over prayer needs and take time and spend time praying for others and get them saved and get them healed and take that time and love them and care for them. The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. And helping the needy, the workers are so, so few. You know, we're helping those orphan kids like once a week now through Pastor Edwin, but it's taken a lot of work and time to get people involved helping those orphan kids because so many people don't want to help the needy. They just don't care. They drive right by the homeless people after they come out of their churches and won't help them. And it's so hard to get people to help the needy, but the harvest is plentiful, and the workers are few, Jesus said. But he calls us, Jesus, to help the needy people in the parable of the sheep and the goats. James 1:27 calls us to help the orphans and the widows, and we need to be doing that if we're doing the will of God and preaching the word of God, getting people out of sin, teaching them to obey everything in the Bible from the Great Commission, Matthew 28:18-20. Few people want to do that because, you know, people get upset with you and get mad at you when you call them out of their sin, when you tell them that they should also, you know, probably go get baptized in water as well as believing in Jesus and things like that. They get upset at you, and, you know, the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. So Jesus would ask us to please go out there and love people and be workers, do the will of God, get people out of their sin, pray for others, share testimonies, help the needy, preach the word of God. It's all part of doing the will of God so we can be welcomed into heaven and not just say, Lord, Lord, and be called workers of iniquity, because if anyone knows to do good and doesn't do it, they're living in sin, James 4:17. So I hope we can truly live for Jesus and do the will of God. God bless all.
A farmer and a teacher, a hooker and a preacher, riding on a midnight bus bound for Mexico. One was headed for vacation, one for higher education, and two of them were searching for lost souls. That driver never ever saw the stop sign. 18-wheelers can't stop on a dime. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That farmer left to harvest a home and 80 acres, the faith and love for growing things in his young son's heart. And that teacher left her wisdom in the minds of lots of children and did her best to give them all a better start. And that preacher whispered, can't you see the promised land? As he lay his blood-stained Bible in that hooker's hand. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Father's not for them. Heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That's the story that our preacher told last Sunday as he held that blood-stained Bible up for all of us to see. He said, bless the farmer and the teacher and the preacher who gave this Bible to my mama who read it to me. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, now I guess we know. It's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of highway.
Amen and amen. Praise God. Thank you, Brother Boyd. Wow, what awesome testimonies, awesome prayer. Well, just an awesome word. If the people would only reach out and take a hold and hear what thus saith the Lord. Thank you, brother. We appreciate you. We're praying for you and your family. In your ministry, the work that God's got you doing, may you be blessed abundantly. Once again, we thank God for you, Brother Boyd London Thomas. Hope one day to get to meet you in person. Amen. I really look forward to that. I love meeting the anointed men and women of God that I come across on these radio broadcasts as well as the Facebook pages. I just love when you meet somebody and you can pray for them, anoint them with oil, and meet each other and just let the love of God flow from breast to breast. It's awesome. I thank God that God allowed us to cross paths. I thank God that he put it upon your heart to help us right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. We're praying for laborers. Amen. Praying for those that'll get a zeal and get on fire to share their testimonies and realize they are overcomers by the word of their testimony and the blood of the Lamb. So thank you once again, brother. I love you. Tell all your family I said howdy, and we're praying for them. We thank God for you. Like I said, may God continue to bless you and your family as you continue to be a blessing to others, my friend. God bless. All right. Let me move on now. I want to ask the question, amen, to those of you that listen live or whether you're listening by way of the archive. Are you saved? Are you saved? Have you repented? Have you denied yourself? Have you thought about where you will spend eternity? You see, a lot of people, they think they're saved, but the fruit says otherwise. They're not saved. A lot of people, lots and lots of people, are on that old wide road, my friend. You must remember that hell enlarges its borders every day. So I asked you again, are you saved? Have you repented? Have you went to the Lord with a broken heart and a contrite spirit? Have you cried out and said, Lord, I'm a sinner in need of a Savior? Have you made the decision to where you will spend eternity? You see, because now, listen, you may say, well, you know, I've not thought about it. I'm not going to get involved in these churches or this religious movement. I'm just going to just let everybody alone and let everybody leave me alone. It don't work that way. See, because the truth is, yeah, if you don't accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, you made a choice. And you die, if you met death right now, and you do not confess Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, you have not repented, you have not cried out to God, you will lift your eyes in torment. You will hear one day the Lord say, "Depart from me, for I never knew you." Now, there's a lot that thinks they're saved, and they go to church. They're faithful to their church, to the building, to the people in the building, to one another. They're faithful. They help each other. They love each other openly with hugs and kisses and handshakes and greetings. But and they've done prayed miracles. They've sharing what word they know. But yet the Lord's going to say one day to some, could it be you? You know where you're at with God. He's going to say, "Depart from me, for I never knew you, you workers of iniquity." Some are going to say, "But Lord, didn't we cast out demons? Didn't we do all these wonderful things in your name?" Yeah, he's still going to say, "Depart from me, for I never knew you." Now, this is real. And this is the line drawn in the sand. If you've listened to this program, whether it be live or by way of the archive, it's decision time. You're hearing the truth. Brother Boyd has called in and shared the gospel. The truth is being cried out loud right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox by Brother Boyd, myself, and many others that call in and share their testimonies, by those that come into the chat room and pray for the prayers and the needs of others and share scriptures and just encourage you to reach out and take a hold of the hand of the unchanging great I Am. But right now, I asked you, are you saved? Are you saved? Because, my friend, either the blessings of God is upon you and your house, or the wrath of God is upon you and your house. That's the truth. Oh, you may think, "Well, now, I don't go to church, and I don't confess Jesus, and I got a pretty good life." You may think you do. And you may have a job that pays $50 an hour. You may have all the things that a person could want of this world. 5 cars, 10 bathroom brick house, like a castle. You know, you may have the prettiest house on the block. You may have the most money in the bank. But if you don't have Jesus Christ in your heart and you don't have the love of God, you're a sounding brass, man. You're nothing. You're gonna die. Yeah, you're going to die. It's appointed unto man, death. You're going to die. You're going to meet death. Whether it be tonight, tomorrow, next, I don't know. That's up to God. But you're going to meet it, and so am I. Do you hear me? Unless you please God and he just take you out. Amen. You're gonna be changed. And you're either going to hear Jesus say, "Enter in or depart from me." That's real. That's true. So I asked you again, are you saved? You see, if you're not born again, you'll know why I see the kingdom of God. Now, I know that in today's world, we've got a lot of different styles of ministers, a lot of different denominational names, a lot of different people that's claiming that, you know, God told them to go do this, go do that. Well, now, here's how you can tell if God's involved in it. You try it. There's many spirits that come at you. So you try the spirits to see if it's of God. How do you try a spirit? You line it up with the Word of God. You see, if it does not line up with the Word of God, my friends, it's not of God. You understand? It's this simple. I'm just talking to you from my heart to your heart as I asked you the most important question you'll ever be asked in your life. Are you saved? Not are you a faithful church member. I'm not asking you if you go to church. I'm asking you, are you saved? I'm not asking you, do you know about Jesus Christ? I'm asking you, do you know him as your personal Lord and Savior? You know, I heard a man preach the other night that said he would tell his own mother to shut up if she got out of the, or talk foolish, or tried to use her authority over man. And, you know, I know the Word of God, but I also know that if you honor your parents, this commandment comes with a promise. You know, it does. It really does. You shall live long, have a long life. I'm telling you, be blessed by God. So as I pondered that sermon that that individual shared, and I thought about the words, and I thought how easy it is that these different people claim different denominational names, and how they try to stir you and I into joining their denomination instead of joining the body of Christ. I want you to start paying attention to the places you go, and you hear the Word of God being presented in many different places. I want you to start checking that with the Word of God. I pray that you check the Gospel Music Radio every time, whether it be me or any other minister on these airways. I pray that you've got your Bible in hand. I pray that you've read. I pray that you continue to read, and that you say, wait a minute, that doesn't line up with the Word of God, and that you call us on it. Anybody, me, anybody, it don't matter who it is, that you say, wait a minute, show me something, help me understand why you're saying this or why you believe this. Show me with the Word of God. You see, we're begotten by the Word of God. I love singing the name that God gave me, the Gospel Music Jukebox radio program. We're sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ through word, testimony, and song. You know, I love music, but now I'm begotten by the Word. You understand? You're begotten by the Word. Listen, man, we need the Word of God. Without it, we will die. We will starve to death spiritually. We don't need no garbage. I mean, you can't live off of garbage. You got to have the truth. And the truth shall set you free. You understand? And Jesus is the truth. So, now there's a lot of things going on. I believe the Pope made a statement just the other day. Pope Francis there talking about if you own a gun, you can't be a Christian. You know? I thought, now man, how many people going to listen to that garbage and believe it? How many, you know, how many people are flocking after the Pope? How many people are being deceived because he's speaking and you're not? Well, you don't call and share your testimony. You don't call in and participate in a live program. You don't call and be heard. All you do is sit and complain about what's going on around you. Well, we want to give you an opportunity. If you answered the question that I asked, are you saved? And you said yes, pick up the phone. Dial 1-931-229-0768 and let the world know. You see, it's not only going to help you because you're an overcomer with the word of your testimony and the blood of the Lamb, but it's going to help someone else. You don't even realize how powerful your testimony is. You don't, or you'd be calling. Not only here, you'd be writing letters. You'd be sharing it at Walmart. You'd be sharing it at your job site. Man, you'd be sharing it everywhere you go. Every time you had an opportunity, man, you would be telling people how good and the good things God has done in your life and how good God is. You would be crying loud because we're running out of time. So I asked you again, are you saved? Yeah, you can say that I've got a show me attitude, especially those of you that are friends on my Facebook page. If you're there, why are you there? Why are you there? If you're there, if you're not there to hear the gospel, because that's all we talk about, then why are you there? You being nosy or what? Think about it. Why are you there? if you don't like the fact that we're going to continue to share the gospel, if you don't like the fact that we're going to continue to tag you on Facebook, in our postages, in our radio programs, then simply defriend me. I'll continue to pray that God's will be done in your life. I would ask you to pray for me. But I'm not on Facebook to just chitter-chat, and I'm not on there to check out the local gossip going on, and I'm not on there to waste my time, because I'm held accountable for my time and what I do with it, and so are you. And I know, and I feel in my heart, we're running out of time, and there's souls hanging in the balance. So I'll ask you again, are you saved? Now, I would advise you to quit worrying about what people think about you and get concerned with what God knows about you, because he knows you better than you'll ever know yourself. Now, if you're not where you need to be with God, just simply repent and quit sinning. Yes, you can quit sinning. Quit blaming the devil for everything going on in your life and around you. And really step up and realize that you've made some bad decisions. You see, you're so used to hunting someone to blame. The devil gets lied on more than anybody I know. And that's the truth. You tell me. I'm gonna play some music, and then I'll recheck the phone lines. I want you to tell me, if you're listening live or by way of the archive, you tell me. Is not the devil in chains? Is he chained up? Will he be loosed for a while? You tell me. Is not the devil chained up? Listen, I use a phrase. In my mind's eye, I can see the devil in Florida fishing. I can. And all these people saying, look what the devil done to me. Look what the devil done to me. It ain't everyone that the devil possessed that chose to smoke marijuana. You made a choice, or chose to shoot that juice into your arms. No, you made a choice. It ain't everyone that is devil possessed. No, you made a choice. You gave in to peer pressure. You wanted to fit into the club. You wanted to belong to something. So you sold out, and you made a bad choice. Now, the devil didn't make you make the bad choice. Choose you this day, whom will you serve? Today is the day of salvation. I'll ask you again, are you saved? The devil gets way too much credit. See, when you begin to blame the devil, you're praising him. Have you thought about that? Why don't you just step up to the plate and say, hey, okay, I made some bad choices. I'm a sinner in need of a Savior. It's that easy. Run to Christ with a broken heart and a contrite spirit. Realize, awake, look at the light, listen to what thus saith the Lord, and realize that you can make a choice right now while you're alive. When you're dead, you don't get to make a choice. You're dead. You understand? This is real. Are you saved? Has the devil done all this to you, or have you made bad choices? Now, the devil's done some. I know that. Because in the spirit realm, he's seeking whom he may devour. Have you just gave up and gave room to the devil? Have you allowed him to move in and take up residence? Well, you can be set free. Yes, you can. You can be delivered. The devil in the spirit realm that has entered into your dwelling can be cast out through and by the authority in the Word of God. Choose you this day, whom will you serve? It's your choice. But I sure wish people would quit giving the devil credit for things he's not doing. I surely do. Be blessed. We'll be right back, and we'll check our phone lines again.
I was in my early 40s with a lot of life before me when a moment came that stopped me on a dime. I spent most of the next days looking at the x-rays, talking about the options and talking about sweet time. I asked him when it sank in that this might really be the real end. How's it hit you when you get that kind of news? Man, what'd you do? And he said, I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a full name Blue Mansion, and I love deeper. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. He said, I was finally the husband that most of the time I wasn't. I became a friend wouldn't like to have. And all of a sudden going fishing wasn't such an imposition. And I went three times that year, I lost my dad. Well, I finally read the good book and I took a good long hard look at what I'd do if I could do it all again. I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a full name Blue Mansion, and I looked deeper and I spoke sweeter and I gave forgiveness I'd been denying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like dying. Like tomorrow was a gift and you got eternity. Think about what you do with it. What did you do with it? What did I do with it? What would I do with it? Skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds as it was flying.
Hello, Brother Eddie. I love you, and God bless you. I'm praying for you all. I wanted to read a great scripture here that nobody can hide from. This is Revelation chapter 20, verse 11, the great white throne judgment. Then I saw a great white throne, and him who sat on it, from whose face the heaven and earth and heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, standing before God, and books were open. Another book was open, which is the book of life, and the dead were judged according to their works by the things which were written in the books. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and Hades delivered up the dead who were in them, and they were judged, each one according to his works. Then death and Hades were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And anyone not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. So I got to ask you, is your name in the book of life? Are you going to go to heaven or are you going to go to hell? You can't get away from this. Every single person is going to stand before God and the books are going to be open. Everything that you've done in your life is going to be recorded in the books. Your works, the way that you've lived, is going to be recorded and laid bare before God. And if you have done evil things and bad things, you will be cast into hell. If you've been a worker of iniquity, as it says in Matthew chapter 7, you'll be cast into hell. Will your name be in the book of life? Will you go to heaven? Will you go to hell? See, there's more to it than just than being bad, that we're also called to do good works. Matthew chapter 7 calls us to do the will of God. As you stand before God, will you have met the needs of the needy people, as we're called to do in the parable and the sheep and the goats, or will you be called a goat and sent to hell? Anyone who knows the good they should do and does not do it is living in sin, James 4:17. How will you have been praying for others and taking the time to pray for others and get them saved and freed from their sins and healed? Will you have gone into the world and preached the gospel to all creation and obeyed the Great Commission and made disciples of all nations and helped people to know Jesus? Will you have, preached the word of God as well as praying for others and meeting people's needs? Will you have shared testimonies? We're called to share testimonies. It says that in the book of Revelation. They overcame them by the word of their testimony. God likes testimonies. Jesus likes testimonies. And you see in just so many scriptures in the Ephesians where it says we're saved by grace, that we're also called to do good works. We're told in Titus chapter 11, 12 through 14, that we're supposed to be a peculiar people, zealous for good works. Have we been doing the good works? Have we been doing the will of God as we stand before Jesus at judgment? Or will we just be called workers of iniquity? Matthew chapter 7 says if we don't do good and don't do the will of God, we can be called workers of iniquity and sent to hell. So as we stand before God, as we stand before Jesus on that day of judgment, where will we go? Will we go to heaven or will we go to hell? Have you been doing the will of God? Have you truly been living for Jesus? We can all repent and change. God bless you all. Amen.
Gathered round I could see angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice.
Praise God. Thank you once again, Brother Boyd, for sharing that awesome word. Amen. Thank you, brother. We love you. Continue carrying on. Amen. Praise God. All right, friends, we've come to the part where now I would like to give you a few names here to pray about, and we'll be saying goodnight just in a few moments. First of all, remember to pray for the tent revival that is going on right now. I don't know if it's going to carry on another night or if this was the last night. I don't know. I've not heard no updates on that yet. But let's pray that God just watch over all of them that's involved. Amen. That many souls be won and added into the body of Christ. That the body of Christ be revived and the lost be drawn. Amen. That's Tent Revival with Chris Chaney, my youngest son. And as he's working in the ministry that God gave him, saving America, one soul at a time. So please remember to pray for all those that God has placed around him as the laborers in the ministry. Man, there's many. He's got Brother Joe Wallace and his family. He got Brother Danny Struggs, and they're on the road with him, and they're just doing what God has called them to do as they go forth and share the good news, the gospel of Jesus Christ. Remember to please pray for Brother Boyd, Thomas London, and his family and the ministry that God has him doing and working in as he reaches out. not only here in America, he reaches out overseas also. So if you really want to get involved, check him out. You can comment him here in the chat room, or you can look him up on Facebook, Boyd Thomas London. Get over there, get involved, as well as get involved right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox by simply calling, sharing your testimony, call in live during a live program when that phone's working. It's down tonight. I apologize for that, but it's beyond my control. God knows what he's doing. Amen. So we just leave it in the Lord's hands. Amen. And but when that lines up, we're asking you to call in and participate in a live program. I'd ask you to be much in prayer also for a young man. Well, we call him Petey the Preacher. Amen. Up there in Pikeville, Kentucky. Be much, much in prayer for him and his family. Remember also Brother Philip Williamson and his family. Pray that God just use them and shape them into what he would have them to be. Amen. We miss them. We're used to those faces. Remember to pray also for Pastor Eddie Garrett and the Soul Filling Station Rock Church, that they be found doing what God would have them to do. Amen. Also remember to pray for Pastor Dusty Watson and the ministry, I forgot the name of the ministry. Help me, Brother Boyd. Do you remember? New Beginning Ministry. Amen, I believe. Over there at Pleasant Hill. It's late. I don't want to get tired. But, amen, you want to be much in prayer for Pastor Dusty Watson and his congregation at the New Beginning Ministry right there at Pleasant Hill, just outside of Crossville. Praise God. You talk about a revival. Man, they just come out of one with Brother Donald Harding Jr. Wow, and his wife, and it was awesome. It was awesome. All I can say is when these revivals are sent by God, they're awesome. Amen. So remember to pray for them. Also, I would ask you to pray for all the local churches here in Crossville, Tennessee. Pray for the pastors. Now, let me take just a moment and give you a bit of information. You know, people like to assume a lot of things about what I say instead of asking me. But I know personally a lot of pastors that are in these denominational churches, you know, from the Church of God to the Baptist, Separated Baptist, Independent Baptist, Church of Christ, Methodist, United Methodist. I personally know and talk and break bread and discuss, and we share the Word of God back and forth, and sometimes it gets heated because I love God, and I'm sharing what I see the Word of God saying, and they're sharing what they see, and that's all good. You see, I know that God has put pastors in these denominational churches that do things that's not of God, and they're there to change those things. You got to understand, they're there to change those things, and they're there to teach the will of God. And they've got a lot of barriers that the enemy has placed in front of them. You know, like they got to deal with committees and deal with committees under committees. They got to deal with many people that are stuck in forms of tradition. And they, you know, this change ain't going to take place overnight. It takes time. It takes dedication. It takes men and women of God that are sold out to God, that God has sent into these denominationalism churches to preach the truth, to teach the truth. Yes, the gospel of Jesus Christ, our precious Lord and Savior, his death, burial, and resurrection, the hope that we have through Jesus. They're there, and they have to go through all these barriers, you know, and they could be fired at any time. But I know personally different ones that absolutely preach the Word of God. And they're going to do so as long as God allows them to stay in that organization, because they're sent by God. So don't misinterpret and don't twist my words. You know, now, not all. I know some pastors that are harlots. They're there for the money. They're there to fleece the people of God. They're there to teach garbage. Yeah, I know. They call themselves pastors. But you must remember that the devil himself transformed himself into a minister of light. You got to remember this. The devil's real. And he's working. Yeah, he's working. He's about his job. In the spirit realm. Let's keep it where he's at, where the war is. It's not in the flesh. You understand? I hope you do. I would want to encourage you. I don't care how long you've been going to church. I don't care how faithful you've been to a denomination, a building, or a group of people. I want to encourage you to pray and fast and read the Word of God. Listen. If you're his sheep, you know his voice, and no other voice will you follow. You understand this is real. This is the countdown. We are in the final hours. There are many that are on the wide road. Many. And remember, hell is enlarging its borders every day. If you go there, if you go to hell because you've rejected Jesus Christ, because you rejected the truth. You go there as an intruder, my friend. You don't belong there. God has made a way. There is a way of escape from this awful torment, this place called hell. And Jesus Christ is the escape. He's the key to set you free. For whom the Son is set free is free indeed. Now, I know you were brought up in tradition. And I know that you, some of you listening, that you've been your whole life in that one denomination. And very well could be that God's got you there. All I'm asking that you check yourself and see if you're in the will of God. You see, I don't want your blood on my hands. If you're being deceived, there's many that believe the lie to be a truth. So check it against the Word of God. If you are in any denomination and they are not preaching the truth, man, you need to really pray and pray that God will either save that individual, open their eyes. He may use you to do that. I don't know. But pray and fast and read the Word of God. Because any moment could be our last moment. Your children, your grandchildren, your neighbors, your co-workers, your wife, your husband, your mom, your dad, your aunts, your uncles, all is watching you if you say you're born again, bathed in the blood. If you say you're real with God, then should you say such statements as, well, let's just overlook them? No, you can't overlook sin. Should we say statements like, well, you know, I don't want to talk about this subject. You know, let's just say it's the subject of alcoholism. And because you've got an alcoholic in your family and they go to church twice a week, and they put plenty of money in the plate, and they just want people to leave them alone. So you say, well, now don't run them off. But what good is it doing them if they sit there and sin, and they split hell wide open? Do you understand? This is real. This is real. Meaning well and doing God's will is two different things. Have you give your family to God? Are you willing to stand up and stand on the Word of God, proclaiming His promises and sharing His Word to a lost and dying world? You do that by living it. I like to use this phrase. I use it quite often. Go forth, preach the gospel, and when necessary, use words. You see, because if you love the Lord and you keep His commandments, man, you're like a city that's set on a hill that cannot be hid. You're the bright light that's going to lead them out of the darkness and into the truth. But if you're just, well, taking up space, if you're afraid you're going to offend someone, you're afraid you're going to run them off, then you are binding the Spirit of God. Turn it loose, my friend. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Because they are souls hanging in the balance. Turn it loose. Tell your friends, your family, your loved ones. Tell them. Even your enemies, even the people that make fun of you, even the people that put you down, even the people that lie on you and use you. Tell them the truth. The truth. You see, the truth. Oh, it's going to hurt, but it'll always set the captive free. Tell them the truth. Don't have their blood upon your hands. Tell them the truth. And the truth is that if you reject Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, and you meet death, and you die, you cannot go to heaven. That's the truth. Truth is, if you've accepted Jesus and you're not applying the Word of God, you're just a hearer only and not a doer, as we heard Brother Boyd share with us out of the book of Revelation, you will stand before God. Now, you're either going to hear him say, enter in or depart from me. So I ask that all-important question again, the most important question you'll ever be asked in your life. Are you saved? Now, if you're saved, are you doing what God has called you to do? Loving people, your brothers, your sisters, and the body of Christ. Are you being an example to the people around you and in your life, at work, at the park, at the movie show, wherever you go? Are you an example? Have you denied yourself, picked up your cross, and following Jesus? My friends, get your priorities right. You could be the assistant pastor at a church. And you could be the choir leader. You could be the deacon. You could be the light bearer. You can be whatever title they want to give you. But if you don't have Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I can promise you, if you die without accepting Jesus Christ, that you cannot make heaven your home. That's the truth. So now, as you sit and you contemplate what you've heard tonight throughout the program, it's come down to decision time. This moment, this hour, what are you going to do with Jesus Christ? Are you going to continue to mock him, make fun of him? Are you going to continue to shove away the truth? He loves you, that he laid down his life freely. They didn't take it. He gave it because he loves you. And you can be set free this hour, this moment, right now, right there where you're at. If you're an alcoholic, you can be set free. If you're a drug abuser, you can be set free. If you're a child molester, a wife beater, a talebearer, a liar, a whoremonger, a homosexual, you can be set free. But know this, if you reject Jesus Christ, you're condemned already. Without Jesus Christ, you are a walking dead man. Choose you this day whom will you serve? We're praying for you. We love you. We'd love to hear from you. if you've accepted Jesus Christ by something that was said or done during this program, please let us know. We want to rejoice with you and the angels in heaven. We want to thank God for another brother or sister, another family member. We would love to just praise God with you. Let us know. We'd love to hear from you. Just dial 1-931-229-0768 and shout it loud. Let the world know that God's not dead. He's alive, and he lives forevermore, and he's living in you. That's awesome. Like I said, we'd love to hear from you. Now, also on the other hand, if you've heard something that's bothered you on this program, if you don't like what you're hearing, well, I'd advise you to quit listening. I mean, if we're not feeding you and we're not helping you, we surely wouldn't encourage you to keep listening. If I'm hungry, I'm going where I can get fed. If you're not getting fed here and you're claiming to be saved, then you need to pray for us that we would get more in the anointing, more forth with the word, whatever it is that's in your heart for us. But let us know. Let us know by calling 1-931-229-0768. Share your comments about the program. You see, we need your help. So we're giving you an opportunity to be a doer. Thank you for your time. Thank you to those that prayed for us throughout the program and continue to pray for us. We do desire your prayers. Thank you for taking the time to stop by the chat room. Those of you that jumped in, amen. Thank you. May God bless you and your families. We love you. We encourage you to get things right with God, my friend. But please, when you hear us ministering on denominationalism, if you'll listen closely, I say 99.9 of these denominationalism churches are teaching false doctrines. I don't say all. Did you ever wonder why I don't say the word all? It's because there is a body of Christ. There is people out there that are absolutely on fire for God. They are in some of these denominationalism buildings, and they are crying loud, preaching the word by being a doer. They're loving people. They're sharing the gospel. They're trying to get people into the word of God. They're there. They're there. Because God's got a plan and a purpose for your life, my friend. You see, the truth, God loves you. It's the sin in your life that he hates. God loved you enough that he sent his only begotten son, that whosoever, friend, that's you and me, whosoever believeth, do you believe? I pray that you do. Know that we love you. We're here for you. If you'd like to give me a call or write me a letter, you can do so. My mailing address is 219 Red Fox Drive, Crossville, Tennessee, 38571. If you'd like to call me on the prayer line, my personal cell phone, you just simply dial 1-931-335-1440. You can text that number as well. Know that I'll pray with you and for you. We'd love to hear from you. Thank you once again for stopping by right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. I've been your host. I am Evangelist Eddie Chaney, called and ordained by God. Sometimes I'm held as a man of God. Sometimes I'm loved. Sometimes I'm criticized. Sometimes I'm lied on. Sometimes, yes, I'm even hated. But none of that matters. None of that. None of that matters. Here's what matters. Jesus Christ. That's the truth. And the truth shall set you free. We may not never meet eye to eye. We might not never be in the same location or the same place. But tonight, if you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, you're my brother or sister, mom or dad, you're my family, those that do the will of the Father. So if you've been touched by this program, please let us know. We'd love to hear from you. I'm going to start sharing some letters on some upcoming programs. I've received a few letters out of months of programming. We have 6 letters that I've got that these people are saying that the program helps them, encourages them. And, you know, I'm going to start sharing some of those, amen, throughout the programs. I've also got some hate mail. I'm going to start sharing those too. Amen. That's the truth. Yeah, I receive a whole lot more hate mail than I do the good. But it's what it is what it is. I receive a whole lot of negativity from people that say that I preach too much about homosexuality and lesbianism. They say that they don't like the phrases that I use. Things like, I'll smack the hell right out of you because I love you. And that's true. I would. If you're standing in front of me and I felt you was in danger of dying and you were doing something ungodly, if it took me to smack you to wake you up, I would do that. That's how much I love you. I don't want nobody to miss heaven and make hell their home. That's the truth. I don't. Not even my worstest enemy. And, you know, I don't. These people that, you know, come out here and make fun of me and get in front of the road and laugh at me and spit at me when I go by because I'm saying, they say that I say that you don't have to be water baptized. They tell you a lie. They are lying. I do not say that, have not said that. I do say this, if you repent and you're in the process of repenting. Now, the only reason I can say this is because it's happened to me. I've lived it, and I know for a fact that I have heard people confess salvation. They've even said they saw the Lord and angels. They were in the anointing, and they died. They died while repenting. That's a fact. That's a truth. Now, they're in the hands of a just God. And just like that thief, I believe in my heart, I believe that it's the blood. I believe that they confessed their sins before God. And I believe they heard him say, and they will hear him say on that day, enter in. I believe that. I do. I know it's risky, and I don't encourage no one to do that. Don't say, oh, I can live any way I want to, and I'll just cry out to God. You don't know when you're going to die. Listen, you may lay down and go to sleep, and you ain't got a chance to repent. You better not play games like that, because you'll lose. You understand God's got a purpose and a plan for your life. And these people that were repenting, the circumstance was just like the thief on the cross. There was no time, no room, no way to be water baptized. You understand? But now, just as sure as you live, and you get a new heart, I promise you, you'll want to fulfill the word of God. You will. Now, some people, it takes a day or two to pray it through. Some people, such as myself, I was locked up and couldn't be water baptized immediately. I wanted to be, but it didn't work that way for me. I had to deal with some other issues because I heard voices. I heard God tell me I was forgiven, and the devil told me that I didn't receive and that I was nothing. And so they locked me up. But if you live past this moment of repentance that you're choosing, and you get things worked out right between you and God, and he takes that old stony heart out and gives you a new one and fills you with the Spirit, his Spirit, the Holy Ghost, when he fills you with that, that Spirit leads you to Jesus Christ and all the truth. You understand? It uplifts Jesus. You're going to want to. You're going to have a desire to. You're going to be trying to get that accomplished as quick as you can. You really will. You'll not only want water baptized, but you'll all of a sudden find yourself, I'm talking about when you're saved now, you will find yourself wanting to feed the hungry, wanting to clothe the naked, wanting to take care of the widows and orphans. You'll have a desire. It'll be in there. It'll be there because of the Spirit of God. You understand? That dwells in you. He that's in you, if you're born again, bathed in the blood, is greater than he that's in the world. So you will have a desire to fulfill the Word of God, the will of God in your life, because you're dead. You understand? You're dead. If you accept Jesus Christ, you're dead. You're not your own. You're bought and paid for with a price. That blood, the precious blood of Jesus. You're not, now listen, you're not paid for by works. You can't work your way in. You can't buy your way in. You can't trade, bargain, or plunder your way in. There ain't but one way to enter in to the kingdom of heaven, and that's through and by Jesus. Now, if you don't accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, and you run out and get water baptized, all you done was got wet. That's all you done. Or if you don't accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, and you go out and feed the world, you're still lost. You're still undone. You'll still miss heaven unless you repent and cry out with that broken heart and that contrite spirit and run into the arms of Jesus. That's the truth. You can't work your way in, can't buy your way in, can't do enough good deeds to earn some kind of special reward and think because you didn't repent and cry out to God that and accept Jesus Christ as his personal Lord and Savior. There's no shortcut to heaven. It's Jesus' way or no way, my friend. So this night, if you've listened and you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, this is your moment. This is your hour. Right now, right there where you're at. It's decision time. We pray you reach out, take a hold of the unchanging hand of the great I Am. We pray that you repent and get things right with God. I pray that if you live and you rise up, you listen to me and you listen good. And you rise up, that you get on the phone, that you get in a car, you drive, you tell as many people as possible what happened to you. You let them know that God's not dead. He's alive and he lives forevermore. And you say, somebody, anybody, brothers, sisters in the body of Christ, get the pastors you know, you've heard of, go get them. If you know them to be men and women of God, go get them and say, I want to be water baptized because I'm not ashamed of the death and burial and resurrection of my precious Lord and Savior. You get on the phone and you call those people you know that have needs in their lives. If you live past repentance, you know people that's got needs in their lives, and you got the means to help those individuals. Get on the phone and say, hey, I got some good news. God saved me tonight. I'm a new creature, and I know you have need of some groceries. I want to bless you in Jesus' name. And watch what happens. You become a doer of the Word of God, not a hearer only. This is real. There's a heaven and there's a hell. Where will you spend eternity? It's your choice. We pray that you reach out and you cry aloud and you realize that you're a sinner in need of a Savior and that you get things right between you and God. The rest will work out. I promise it will. If you're not born again, you shall in no wise see the kingdom of heaven. If you do not humble yourself down, I'll tell you this way. Every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord of lords and King of kings. Now, it's easier to do it on this side of eternity. You understand? But you will do it. As you hear him say, depart from me, for I never knew you, you workers of iniquity, if you reject Jesus Christ. Don't turn him away. If you reject Jesus Christ in the truth this night, you are condemned. My friends, It's simple. You're either blessed by God, or your house is under the raft of God. The truth. And the truth shall set you free. If you're listening to men of God that are, well, practicing witchcraft and putting out curses on people and cursing you and your families, I'd advise you to quit listening. You got to know that without love, if you bring forth the word of God, you do it in love. You speak with a boldness such as we ought to. We call out sin because we love you, not because we're mad at you, not because we don't like you. We love you. This is why we share the gospel. This is why we, if we see you sin, we call it out. Because we're wanting you to repent. We're wanting you to stay in the body of Christ. We're wanting you to be with heaven, in heaven with us. It's because we love you. I hate sin, but I love you. You see, and people love to twist words, you know. But I'm going to continue to preach against homosexuality, against lesbianism, against lying, against whoremonging, against cheating, against plotting, against conning, against jealousy. I'm going to continue to preach the word of God. You see, I'm not for sale. I'm not going to tickle your ears so you'll listen to our radio program. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to tickle your ears so you'll befriend us on Facebook. I'm not going to do that. No. My friends, listen. Listen, I fear God, who can destroy both body and soul in the lake of fire. I fear no man. You understand? All you could do to me, you know, is kill me if God allowed. That's it. But God can destroy both body and soul in the lake of fire. Friends, this is real. The moment of decision has arrived for you if you've listened to this program and you do not know Jesus Christ is your personal Lord and Savior. What are you going to do with Jesus now? You've heard the truth. Don't reject it. Don't reject Jesus. He is your only hope to escape that awful place of torment. That's the truth. So you, as you think and ponder about where will you spend eternity, you know whether or not you're where you need to be with God. You know, an alcoholic knows he's an alcoholic. Anybody abusing drugs know that they're addicted to drugs and they have a problem and they don't know how to get out of it. And what you and I have to do is simply love the hell right out of them. We got to love them enough to stand, look them in the eye, and tell them the truth over and over as many times as it takes. Listen, we don't need no more doctors, no more lawyers, no more rehabs. What we need is men and women of God to stand up and preach the gospel, the good news. There's hope for the hopeless. Yes, there is. Maybe the world's told you you're hopeless. Maybe everyone you know around you has given up on you. But God didn't give up. He loved you so much, he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. So once again, I ask everyone listening live or by way of the archive, are you saved? It's the most important question you're ever going to be asked in your life. I'm not asking you if you're a Christian. I'm not asking you if you belong to a church. I'm asking you, are you born again? Do you know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior? If not, right now, right there, this moment, won't you fall down to that old altar of the knees and simply get things right between you and God? If you don't believe there is a God, why don't you taste him and see if he's not good? God's good, my friends. He's good. All right, let me jump over here and check the phone line. I'm going to check the chat. Hey, praise God. We got super guy, I believe. He says, hey, yo, super guy, God bless you. Amen. Welcome into the Gospel Music Jukebox. I have to ask you, I asked everyone that I can when I get a check on the chat room here, do you know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior? Are you a brother in the body of Christ? You can let us know there in the chat room. If not, we'll pray that God touch you and that you would receive Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. If so, we want to say God bless you and welcome, and may God continue to bless you as you continue to be a blessing to others. Super guy. Amen. I like the little, is that a Superman cape? I can't see it. It's red. I can't see the markings on the thing. But anyway, you're welcome into the program. Amen. We'd encourage you to pick up the phone, and we've got a testimony line. You can call in and leave your pre-recorded testimony. We'll try to play it on the program, if not this one, on one in the future. Our live call-in line is down tonight. The phone company, go figure. But usually when we're on the air live, you can call in and participate, ask questions, share your testimony, sing a song or share scripture or pray for the needs of others. But tonight we have to use the testimony line, and that is a pre-recorded line. You simply dial 1-931-229-0768 anytime, as many times as you'd like. You can ask Bible questions. You can share your testimony. We'd love to hear from you. And Super Guy, I hope you take advantage of that line and give us a call. For now, let me run over here and check the phone line. No, let me play a song, then I'll upload the phone and see if the pre-recorded, if we have anything coming in the last few minutes. Amen. All right. Enjoy this song, because God's good. It's undescribable, ain't it? It's better felt than it is told. Amen. All right. You're listening to the Gospel Music Jukebox. I'm your host, evangelist, Brother Eddie Chaney. We'll be right back.
One day shy of 8 years old, Grandma passed away. I was a broken-hearted little boy blowing out that birthday cake. How I cried when the sky let go with a cold and lonesome rain. Mama smiled, said, "Don't be sad, child. Grandma's watching you today. 'Cause there's holes in the floor of heaven, and her tears are pouring down. That's how you know she's watching, wishing she could be here now. And sometimes if you're lonely, just remember she can see. There's holes in the floor of heaven, and she's watching over you and me. Seasons come and seasons go, nothing stays the same. I grew up, fell in love, met a girl who took my name. Year by year, we made a life in this sleepy little town. I thought we'd grow old together. Lord, I sure do miss her now. But there's holes in the floor of heaven, and her tears are pouring down.
that's how I know she's watching, wishing she could be here. And sometimes when I'm lonely, I remember she can see. There's holes in the floor of heaven, and she's watching over. My little girl is 23. I walk her down the aisle. It's a shame her mom can't be here now to see her lovely smile. They throw the rice, I catch her eye as the rain starts coming down. She takes my hand, says, "Daddy, don't be sad, 'cause I know Mama's watching now." And there's holes in the floor of heaven, and her tears are pouring down. That's how you know she's watching, wishing she could be here now. And sometimes when I'm lonely, I remember she can see. Yes, there's holes in the floor of heaven, and she's watching over you and me. Watching over you and me. Watching over you and me. Watching over you and me.
Hello, Brother Eddie. I love you and God bless you. And we're praying for you. God bless everyone who listens to these programs. We love you all and we're praying for you. And one of the things I was just going to talk about is that you know, if you really turn your life over to Jesus, you got to get born again. You got to be a new creation, born again. Jesus talks about being born again, and it's an important thing. See, I grew up in a Christian family. My mom and dad are involved. I've been on staff of the church and different things. We're running the preschool program from the young kids. But, you know, I never really knew Jesus or got born again because I was into the pornography and cursed, used God's name in vain, did all that kind of stuff. I cursed a lot, got angry a lot, even though I went to church sometimes with my parents, and I never truly was born again. But then, you know, when I truly found out that I was living in sin and not saved, I got down on my knees and confessed Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior. Jesus came into my heart and life and changed me, and I got born again, and I was also went and got baptized also. And I got that heart of love in me from Jesus where those sins just went away. I wasn't controlled by the pornography and lust or the anger and the cursing and all that anymore. When I truly got born again, Jesus helped me to really change and to repent and get those sins out, and then change me where I had that desire where I wanted to help the churches grow and study the Bible with people and help people know Jesus and get saved. And when I started helping needy people, the homeless people and people in prisons and orphan kids, like we've been helping the orphan kids through Pastor Edwin all the time, and I just started loving helping people and serving people, and I look for ways to do that all the time, and I ask Jesus to help me to help other people, because I'd far rather be helping orphan kids and loving orphan kids than sitting there watching pornography and sinning, doing those horrible sins that would have sent me to hell. I'm just so grateful to be changed, and I thank Jesus so much for changing me. And I hope, you know, and pray and ask that anybody who hasn't really turned their life over to Jesus can turn their life over to Him, get born again, be set free from those sins, get a heart of love where they can go out there and start doing the will of God and helping people, and we could all be a great family in the kingdom of God and be welcomed into heaven. And I just thank Jesus also for all of us, for helping all of us to get born again and truly change where we can repent of those sins and then go out and do the will of God and help people and live for Jesus in the kingdom. And we love you all, and we're praying for you, and God is good, and Jesus is good. No matter what you've done, Jesus will help you. He'll help you repent, and he'll forgive you. Jesus tells us all that we can repent. Repent or perish, he says. Repent or perish. We've got to be born again. God bless you all. Amen.
Come into the house of the Lord. Come into the house of the Lord. There's love overflowing, a joy that you be knowing. When you come into the house of the Lord. Come into the house of the Lord. Salvation for us all. Love and salvation, one and all. Come into the house of the Lord. Come into the house of the Lord. With love overflowing, a joy that you've been knowing. When you come into the house of the Lord. Come into the house of the Lord. Redemption did begin. Come into the house of the Lord. Come into the house of the Lord. No one will be denied. No prayer will be ignored. When you come into the house of the Lord. Come into the house of the Lord.
Come into the house of the Lord. Praise God. Thank you once again, Brother Boyd London Thomas, for calling in and sharing that awesome word. Praise God. Man, I just love you. I love you, family. I want to say thank you to everyone that stopped by the chat room here. Amen. You guys are just awesome. We'd love to hear from you. We encourage you. Hey, Super Guy. Hey, man, we encourage you to come back. Check us out. We pray and hope that you're saved. If not, know that you can be. Amen. As we've heard Brother Boyd talk about and myself throughout tonight, if you'll go to Jesus, if you'll realize you're a sinner in need of a Savior, if you'll just repent, he'll no wise cast you out. He'll take you. Hey, he'll put you on the potter's wheel. Remember this. We are the clay and he is the potter. Won't you allow God to shape you into what he would have you to be this night? Good to see a visitor drop by. Amen. We hope that we've said or done something that would encourage you to get a little closer to Jesus. Amen. All right. Raise your hands up as we're just going to spend a few moments worshiping God through song here. Let's just worship God in spirit and truth. And I'll be right back with a few more prayer requests and comments. Amen. Thank you, Brother Boyd. We love you too, brother, and your family. You got an awesome family, man. They're on fire. They're working for the Lord. Your mom, your dad, my God, and your grandma. Man, she's so special. I don't know, you know, reminds me of mine. She just touched my heart the first time we prayed for her. And it's just awesome what God does. Amen. It's better felt than it is told. I mean, as much as I try to explain this feeling, I can't do it. I just, there's no way. There's not enough words. It can't be described. Amen. But I love you guys. You're awesome. So know that. That's from my heart to you, man. We love you, me and my wife, everyone in the chat room. All we do when we're not on the air, we talk about the Word of God. We share it and we discuss the things going on right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. And your name comes up all the time because we all say, we know you're on fire for God. It's evident. The fruit tells on you, brother. You've been felt guilty as charged. You are definitely a child of God, on fire for God. And not just a hearer, but a doer. And man, you're setting forth examples. You're letting your light shine. And I just love that you're like myself. You try to be busy in the kingdom of God. Amen. Praise God. But know that I've heard nothing but good reports from everyone that's, you know, listened throughout the months here in the chat room. My God, brother, they all love you. They just love to hear you when you're obeying the Lord, and it's good. Amen. So keep on keeping on. All right, let's raise our hands up. And let's just spend a few moments praising God and thanking him, because he is truly worthy of our praise, the glory, and the honor. Amen. Amen. All right. We'll be right back. You're listening to the Gospel Music Jukebox. Be blessed.
I'm busy every day as I travel on my way to the city far beyond the sky. And there is not a doubt that time is running out as harvest time is drawing nigh. Lord, I need a little time to gather in the grain before I leave this world behind. I'm ready when you call me, give me just a little more time. Lord, give me just a little more time. Give me just a little more time. So many precious souls are lost in sin. So many may be left behind. I got a lot of things that I need to do before I leave this world behind. I'm ready when you call me, but give me just a little more time. Well, I need a little time to lay before my Lord before the final judgment day. And I need a little time to preach the holy word to the sinner man along life's way. every moment that I have. The tarry here below, I'll try to make my lamp to shine. I'm ready when you call me, but give me just a little more time. Well, give me just a little more time. Give me just a little more time. So many precious souls are lost in sin. So many may be left behind. I got a lot of things that I need to do before I leave this world behind. I'm ready when you call me, but give me just a little more time. Lord, give me just a little more time. Give me just a little more time. So many precious souls are lost in sin. So many may be left behind. I got a lot of things that I need to do before I leave this world behind. I'm ready when you call me. Give me just a little more time. I'm ready when you call me. But give me just a little more gospel story of Noah's Ark. When God looked down on this old world, his heart was heavy and sad. The world he'd made and the man he'd loved had all turned wicked and bad. As he looked over his creation, he was grieved by his own plan. But just before he destroyed everything he loved, he found him a righteous man. Brother Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah was a righteous man. He walked with his God day by day, holding to his hand. He worked without ceasing, preached without preaching. That's the truth that shall ever stand. Brother Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah was a righteous man. Well, God said to Noah, build a boat and we'll call it an ark. Build it long, deep and wide. I'm gonna tell you before it starts. I'm gonna send to you a two by two, every good and living thing. But gather up your family and shut the door, cause brother, it's gonna rain. For 40 days and 40 nights, the water came a-pouring down. The tears from God Almighty's eyes covered everything on the ground. Men were screaming, women were crying, Noah heard it day and night. But everything on the other side of that door disappeared clean out of sight. Brother Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah was a righteous man. He walked with his God day by day, holding to his hand. He worked without ceasing, preached without preaching. That's the truth that shall ever stand. Brother Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah was a righteous man. All right. And then one day the rain stopped falling and the ark came to a rest. High and dry was old brother Noah on the top of Mount Ararat. Well, he opened up the window and sent the Lord a dove. Well, the dove brought back an olive branch and we all got a bowl of love. Brother Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah was a righteous man. He walked with his God day by day, holding to his hand. He worked without ceasing, preached without preaching. That's a truth that shall ever stand. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah was a righteous man. Well, Noah was a righteous man. Yeah, Noah was a righteous man.
God. All right, guys and girls, boys and gentlemen, ladies and friends and foes and everyone that's listening, it's come time to say good night. Hey, man, we love you. We thank God for each and every one of you. Please, if you've listened to the program and you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, won't you do that right now? What time you have time, my friend? Won't you get things settled between you and God? It's your choice. Choose you this day. Whom will you serve? Know that we love you. We want to thank Boyd Thomas London for just being obedient to God. There's no other way to say it. Brother, thank you. Look forward to many, many of your calls. We continue to download these to CDs. We'll continue to give them away. Amen. So please know that if you're listening to the program, whether live or by way of the archive, if you call in, we do download the programs. We give them away, all the prayers for others. We need prayers for others. We need prayers for the homeless. We need prayers for those that are addicted to drugs and alcohol. We need prayers of deliverance. Some people are asking for prayer requests of deliverance from watching porn, deliverance of ungodly sexual acts. We need prayers for others that we can burn down to those CDs. Amen. And that we can continue to give those away. So please know, as many times as you feel led, as God will put on your heart, my God, you want something to do for the kingdom of God? the body of Christ, hey, you get involved. Pick up the phone, dial 1-931-229-0768, and just bombard us with prayers for others. We really, really need those. We do, and that's the truth. Amen. So encourage your family, your friends, man, your workers, co-workers, everyone around you. Say, hey, here, call this number and just say a prayer for the homeless. Just say a prayer for the hungry. Just say a prayer for those that are addicted to drugs. Just say a prayer for those that are living in the lifestyle of the homosexuality. Just pray for them that they will see and hear the truth. Just pray for the alcoholic. Pray for the drug infested. Pray for that child molester. Pray for the ones that are going out and murdering people. Pray for them. We want to download these, get them in the hands of people all over the world, not only America. Now remember, if you'd like to receive a CD, amen, well, you can simply write me at 219 Red Fox Drive, Crossville, Tennessee, 38571, or call me on my prayer line, my personal cell phone, which is 1-931-335-1440. And give me your mailing information. We'll send them out. We're not going to ask you for money. We're not going to try to bombard you. We don't do that. That's just not what God told me to do. We're not going to try to sell you nothing. We've never sold nothing pertaining to the gospel of Jesus Christ. We don't do that. Don't believe in it. Can't find it in the Word. I don't do it. So please tell your friends, your family, call. Call every day. At least once a day. You know, testimony or prayers for others, or call and share a verse of scripture with us. But do something. Amen. I know some of you are doing plenty. You're busy in your ministries. You're busy doing, applying the Word of God in your life right there where you're at. And that's good. That's a good busy. If you're that busy and you can't call, that's a good busy. So praise God that you're busy in the body of Christ. But if you find you have 3 minutes spare in your time, please call and leave a pre-recorded prayer request, testimony, prayers for others, Bible question, or just shout howdy. I'd love to hear from you. Know that we love you, but remember this: God loves you most, my friends, that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever, that's you and I, whosoever would believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Now it's your choice. You've come to the moment of decision. Choose you this day. Whom will you serve? We're praying for you. We'd love to hear from you. May God continue to bless you and your families as you continue to be a blessing to others, my friend. As we share this song, we'll say good night. And God bless.
I'm trusting to the unseen hand that guides me through this weary land, and some sweet day I'll reach that strand, still guided by the I long to see my Savior's face and sing the story of His grace, and there that golden strand I'll praise Him for His guiding hand. I'm trusting to sweet.